You, O Lord, are close and all your ways are truth. From of old I have known of your decrees, for you are eternal. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves for our celebration. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Unworthy servants that we are, O Lord, grieved by the guilt of our deeds, we pray that you may gladden us by the saving advent of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Raise a glad cry, you barren one who did not bear. Break forth in jubilant song, you who were not in labor. For more numerous are the children of the deserted wife than the children of her who has a husband, says the Lord. Enlarge the space for your tent. Spread out your tent clothes unsparingly. Lengthen your ropes and make firm your stakes, for you shall spread abroad to the right and to the left. Your descendants shall dispossess the nations and shall people the desolate cities. Fear not, you shall not be put to shame. You need not blush, for you shall not be disgraced. The shame of your youth you shall forget, the reproach of your widowhood no longer remember. For he who has become your husband is your maker. His name is the Lord of hosts. Your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel, called God of all the earth. The Lord calls you back like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit, a wife married in youth and then cast off, says your God. For a brief moment I abandoned you, but with great tenderness, I will take you back. In an outburst of wrath for a moment, I hid my face from you. But with enduring love, I take pity on you, says the Lord, your Redeemer. This is for me like the days of Noah, when I swore that the waters of Noah should never again deluge the earth. So I have sworn not to be angry with you or to rebuke you. Though the mountains leave their place and the hills be shaken, my love shall never leave you, nor my covenant of peace be shaken, says the Lord who has mercy on you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me. I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies' rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the netherworld. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit. Response.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Sing praise to the Lord, you his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name, for his anger lasts but a moment. A lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn rejoicing. Response.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You change my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever I will give thanks. Response. Please stand to honor the Holy Gospel.
Alleluia, Alleluia. Prepare the way of the Lord, make straight his path. All flesh shall see the salvation of God. Alleluia, Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. When the messengers of John the Baptist had left, Jesus began to speak to the crowds about John. What did you go out to the desert to see? A reed swayed by the wind? Then what did you go out to see? Someone dressed in fine garments. Those who dress luxuriously and live sumptuously are found in royal palaces. Then what did you go out to see? A prophet? Yes, I tell you, and more than a prophet. This is the one about whom Scripture says, "Behold, I am sending my messenger ahead of you. He will prepare your way before you." I tell you, among those born of women, no one is greater than John, yet the least in the kingdom of God is greater than he. All the people who listened, including the tax collectors, who were baptized with the baptism of John, acknowledged the righteousness of God. But the Pharisees and scholars of the law, who were not baptized by him, rejected the plan of God for themselves. My dear sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord. Good day to everyone. Ngayon ay December 15. Bukas, December 16, magsisimula na ang mga simbang gabi. And I think this is your last regular mass in the school year sa taong ito, 2022. Kaya naman, naisip ko na ang magiging homily natin ay parang reminder na lang sa atin para i-celebrate natin ang Christmas. Ano? Ang mga points for us to have a meaningful Christmas vacation. Yung mga reflection ko, ang reminders ko, sabihin nating tatlong C. Three C's. Ano? Number one C. Ano? Sa pagsiselebrate natin ang Christmas, una, is to connect. First letter C is connect. Use this Christmas vacation to connect with your relatives and friends. Ito, alam naman natin, culture, tradition natin as Filipinos, na ang Christmas season, napakahalaga sa ating bilang isang family. And Christmas is all about family. Sana, you connect with your families and friends. You connect with your relatives. Yung mga dating hindi nyo nakakausap, mga tito at tita, sana makausap nyo kahit papaano. And kapag sinabing connect, hindi lang naman sa ibang tao. Use this Christmas vacation to connect with yourself. Huwag masyado munang mag-Facebook, TikTok. Gamitin ang Christmas vacation para mapahinga yung sarili. Madami kayong naging academic loads at netong mga nakakaraang buwan. Itong Christmas vacation is also to give you break to connect with your inner self. Ayun yung number one. To connect with others and with yourself. Nang sa gayon, pagkatapos ng taon na ito, makikita natin ano bang dapat baguhin, ano bang dapat i-improve. And 2023 will be a, sabihin nating, mas mabuting taon para sa atin. Connect. Number two is church. Go to the church. Di lang kayo magbabakasyon, nasa bahay, nasa bakasyonan. Christmas is all about Jesus Christ. Walang Pasko kung wala si Jesus. Walang Pasko kundi dahil sa simbahan. Kaya sana, if you may, you attend Mesa de Gallo, Simbang Gabi, go to the church, pray, talk to God, connect with Jesus. Remember, Christmas is not about what the world tells us. Christmas is about Jesus Christ, about our salvation. Kaya sana, you go to the church, especially on Christmas Day. Magpasalamat sa Diyos sa lahat ng biyaya. Magpasalamat sa Diyos sa lahat naman ng nagmamahal sa atin. And thank God for another year na nag-aantay sa atin. Church. Go to the church. Connect. Church. And third is charity. Christmas, as we know, as we all know, is the season of love. Season of charity. Kaya sana, huwag natin palalampasin ang Christmas vacation na hindi tayo nakagawa, hindi tayo nakatulong kahit sa isang tao. Maraming regalong matatanggap natin. Maraming regalong magagaling sa ninong at ninang, sa mismong parents natin. Sana tayo din makapagbigay ng pagmamahal sa iba. Charity. Christmas is the season of love. Connect, go to the church, do an act of charity. Yun lamang, reminders ni Father, you may sana magkaroon kayo ng isang grace-filled and meaningful Christmas vacation. Amen. Prayers of the faithful, the coming of our Redeemer was foretold by the prophets by preaching repentance for sins. John the Baptist heralded his coming. In the spirit of penance, let us ask God's help through our prayers. Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Church may reveal the glory of the Lord for all people to see. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians' leaders may become instruments of truth and justice and lead their people in the way of peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our hearts may be open to receive the message of the prophets speaking like a voices in the wilderness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That others may see the patience of God in the way we treat them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those whose death we recall may enjoy pardon and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Most loving Father, look upon the needs of your people and grant our petitions as we prepare for your Son who lives and reigns with you forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humbled spirit and contrite hearts, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take these, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of our faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Francisco, our Bishop, Noli, his auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Our Lady of Peace and Good Voyage, with Saint Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles, especially Saint Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you po.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Give eternal life to us, receive it. Receive it with your body and blood, Lord Jesus Christ.
Behold Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Corpus Christi, custodiat me in vitam aeternam.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maraming salamat ho sa mga nagsimba ngayon. Salamat sa mga tumulong sa atin sa banal na misang ito, sa kay Sir Sunny Pedulyome, ang campus ministry head ng Our Lady of Peace School, kay Sir Vince, ang ICT ho natin, sa Binangon ng Catholic College, kay La Ma'am Eder, Sir Nasser, at sa inyong lahat na nakiisa, maraming salamat. And from the bottom of our hearts here at Our Lady of Peace School, we greet you an advance Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your families, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.